last day of our trip. Yeah. Until we go to home tomorrow. It's day 8. We are at 8:45.
Yep.
8:45. We are heading to LA now to go to Universal. Yep. We're on a train right now. We missed the train.
Yeah, we missed the train. It was. It came right when we got here, but we couldn't find a way to get
it. Yeah.
There's no entrance to it.
Yeah.
It's like the light rail.
Yeah.
Oh well.
Yeah, we're gonna go. What?
They have chargers.
Oh.
I wish we brought our charger, because then we could charge the external battery all the way up. But I didn't.
Oh well. Anyways, this train is pretty nice.
Yeah, it is. It's really nice. It feels really good to sit.
Yeah, it does.
And I love trains.
I know, me too.
Since we didn't get this train, because it's not ready right now.
Yeah.
We get this train.
Yeah. So yeah, we're gonna head to Universal. Stand in long lines. Hopefully we'll have some time to go and explore LA.
Yes, hopefully.
Hopefully.
At least a little bit of LA.
Yeah.
At least the Charlie's Theater and the Hog Fame. And then after that, my second choice would be Griffith Observatory.
Yep, so we're gonna do that.
We're not gonna go up to the Hollywood sign, but
I wanna see it.
I wanna see it, yeah.
Yeah.
At least from like a little distance.
Yeah.
Morning, welcome aboard Metro 685 service to Los Angeles Union Station. Last call. Upon a park, all aboard.
No, next time. It's harder since we don't have a car. I'd like to do more stuff when we have a car.
Yeah.
I don't have so
next
much.
Next year, hopefully.
Yeah. Hopefully next year. So yeah, we're gonna head to Universal.
Thank you.
shuttle up there, and then we'll be at Universal.
Yeah. Use Hollywood and CityWalk. For the safety and comfort of everyone aboard, there is no smoking on the shuttle. Please remain seated, keeping your arms and legs inside the vehicle at all times until we come to a full and complete stop. If you have an emergency of any kind, please reach out and pull the emergency cord, whether it is on the driver's side or down the center of the trail. Thank you.
France. version. I know. Yeah. We're gonna go to Jurassic Cafe. So has a little bit more of a thrill.
Oh.
What did you think I said?
I thought you said intro.
No.
I was like, what? I just said the other one has more. Storyline.
And
but you feel the bugs in this one.
The what?
You feel the bugs in this one.
Oh, the bugs, yes. You do feel the bugs. That part was creepy.
So, yeah. That's what I was worried about with the other one in the first row.
Right.
That would be, there was nothing.
Yeah. But, now we are heading to Studio Tour, which is all the way up on the top.
But we don't want to miss riding it.
Yeah. We were just on the bottom. Oh. And it's so hot.
Are you excited for this?
Yep, I'm so excited for this. I haven't read this since I was younger.
Oh, please hold a handrail at all times and attend children carefully. For their safety,
yeah, we're gonna go ride the studio tour and then we'll see what we have time for after that. So we're about to ride the studio tour. We're gonna wait in the about a 30-minute long wait. But the ride is gonna be like 40 minutes.
I get to sit for that long too.
Yeah, oh, that's gonna feel amazing. Ted, Animal House. It's alive.
Ooh. Now we're gonna head down this hill in just a moment, but before we do, I wanna take this moment to bring up my special co-host for the day. You guys know him as the host of The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon. It's Jimmy Fallon.
Oh, hey there! You made it! Welcome to the Universal Studio Tour. I'm Jimmy Fallon. I'll be making sure that you get through this experience in one piece. You've got the very best guide.
Cody.
And the greatest driver.
Ryan.
They're the best. I love them. Even though...
Cody.
Owes me $5. I know you guys are excited to get on the tour, but first, a few safety rules.
Now welcome guys to the Universal Timeline. To take a look on either side of the tram, you will notice movie posters. Now, these posters, they represent just a few of the thousands of movies that we've made right here at Universal Studios. Over our 100 years of filmmaking, and we've filmed countless music videos, TV commercials, TV shows, movies, you name it. In fact, if you guys check out that Universal logo on the tops of the posters, you can see how it has evolved over the years. So we make our way down the hill here. Take a look on your left-hand side, and you will see Soundstage 12. Now, that is currently home to the Emmy Award-winning hit singing competition on NBC, The Voice, with celebrity coaches like Blake Shelton, Pharrell Williams, Adam Levine, and Christina Aguilera. As Soundstage 12 is not only the largest soundstage on the Universal lot, it's one of the largest soundstages in the world. Many famous sets have been housed on Soundstage 12, like Dracula's Castle, Scarface's Mansion. It's also where we shot the famous Clock Tower sequence from Back to the Future. And any Taylor Swift fans on board? Her music video, Wildest Dreams, she shot parts of that on Soundstage 12. All of these were used for CSI, which was Crime Scene Investigation, and that starred Ted Danson and Elizabeth Shue. However, nowadays, Soundstage is 23, and the doors are open on 23. They're being used for the new show Superstore, which stars America Ferrera, Ben Felton, and Mark McKinney. And if you look inside, you can see they actually built a Superstore right inside of that soundstage. Now, if you guys will look in front of you, you'll see everyone's favorite person. She's Indian, she's adorable, and she's absolutely hilarious. You guys are so sweet, but I'm not talking about myself. No, I'm talking about Mindy Kaling, who shoots her show, The Mindy Project, which is going to be coming up on your left-hand side. But you know what? Let's get a little bit more from Miss Mindy.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mindy, and welcome to the world-famous Universal Studios Tram Tour. I wish you could join you, but I'm really busy shooting my show, The Mindy Project.
Also, you were banned from Trams because you jumped off one and tried to hug Steven Spielberg.
For your information, he loved it, okay? And Mr. Spielberg, if you're out there, I'm waiting for a close encounter.
Leave the guy alone. He's super busy.
I think we had a connection.
I'm a big fan too, Mr. Spielberg.
Edit this out, please.
And of course, that's being shot on your left-hand side in Soundstage 27. Now, Soundstage 27 is actually a very unique soundstage because it is the only soundstage on the lot that has a pit in the center of it that we fill with water and use to shoot a lot of our water sequences, like we did for Evan Almighty and The Skeleton Key. It's also where we test drove the mechanical shark from Jaws to be dressing rooms for very famous stars like Doris Day, Rock Hudson, Tony Curtis, Jimmy Stewart, but nowadays they are offices for some of the top writers and directors in town, like Illumination Entertainment that brought you Hop, The Lorax, Despicable Me, most recently Minions, and soon, in July, The Secret Life of Pets. On your left-hand side, underneath the Hannibal banner, that's a very famous bungalow. That's Bungalow 5195. Now, that is currently home to the De Laurentiis Company, which brought you the legend of Hannibal to the small and the big screen. As you guys might have noticed, next to that 5195, there was a very familiar silhouette. The incomparable Alfred Hitchcock, the master of chills and thrills, known for movies like Psycho, Vertigo, The Birds, Rear Window. And the reason he's on that building? That used to be his old office. And guys, I have been in there. There is red carpet still on the floor. That man knew how to live. And on your left-hand side is construction for two new sound stages, so you can see what the kind of skeleton of a soundstage looks like. Now, Hitchcock was a master of chills and thrills, and he actually had cameo appearances in all of his movies. These sets here are what we call our Metropolitan sets. Now, as we pass through here, you will notice that these buildings, they look very strong and sturdy, which they are. They totally are. But they might also look like there's a whole lot going on inside. No. There is nothing going on inside these buildings because these buildings are fake. They're what we call facades. It's just the fronts and the sides of buildings, and then your imagination fills in the rest. We don't actually build interiors. Now, of course, there are a few exceptions when we do build interiors, and when that happens, we call those practical sets, and we're going to visit a couple of those later on in the tour. But as we make our way through here, welcome guys to our London Square Street. Down on your right-hand side, you'll get a glimpse of our Brownstone Street. Now, Brownstone Street has been used in many movies like Bruce Almighty, as well as a couple of music videos, Michael Jackson's Black or White music video, as well as his Smooth Criminal music video. And welcome also to our New York Street. Now, our New York Street has been used for many TV shows like Quantum Leap, How I Met Your Mother, episodes of House, as well as most recently, American Ninja Warrior, which is on the Esquire Network on Wednesday nights. Their current season was shot right out here on our New York Street. Now, movies that we've shot down here on our New York Street include Captain America, The First Avenger, as well as Transformers, which starred Shia LaBeouf and Megan Fox. Now, that called for a great deal of collaboration between the film's director, Michael Bay, and Universal Studios. And over the years, we've collaborated with many award-winning directors like Steven Spielberg, Alfred Hitchcock, Clint Eastwood, and most recently, Peter Jackson.
I like films that just take you away from your real life and sweep you up on adventure. Kong literally does that. I mean, you're on board the ship, you're sailing to a lost island, you're encountering monsters and creatures from, you know, prehistoric times. So I was thrilled when Universal invited me back to Star Island. It's great to have you along for the ride.
All day. Okay, you know what, guys? There's only one way to get rid of this, but I'm actually gonna need your help, okay? On board, we have what is called movie magic. You all possess it, I know you do. And we're gonna use it right now, okay? On the count of three, I need you all to say, "Part the waters," with the voice and everything. Ready? One, two, three.
Part the waters.
Oh wow, that was really nice, guys. I saw that hand motion there, and look, there it goes. You guys are some magical people. You know what? Let's get some epic movie music up in here. Yes. Well done, guys. Well done. Now, as we pass through here, you guys might want to pick up any items you have on the ground, because there is a chance that those items could get wet. Okay, thank you so much, guys, for hanging in there with me during that quiet zone. Now, welcome to... But that's just because they had a little shark problem. Nothing to worry about. They caught the shark. In fact, my buddy George, he is the police chief around these parts, and he said it's totally fine if we come on down and hang out. In fact, I'm gonna go off camera because I'm gonna say hi to my buddy George. I've not seen him in a hot minute. Now, he did say he was gonna be doing a final swing of the harbor here, but I'm not seeing him. Oh, that's gotta be him by the police boat. Those bubbles there, what is that? Wait, is that a shark? Wait, does George... okay. Hey, Georgie Purgy, I've got something really important to tell you. I need you to pay attention because there's a shark in the... All right, well, you know what, guys? George had a lot of guts to be out there in the water. A lot of guts. There they are. They're the guts. Okay, so I just don't have a ride home from work today. That's fine, I'll figure it out. Guys, it's gonna be fine. George told me that they put some bait, on that yellow barrel out there in the water. So if the shark gets it, then it's all good and we can get on out of here. Now let's see if he spots it, though. I don't even know what they put on it. Chicken or something? Oh, there it goes, nervous. Oh. Wait, why is that moving? Oh, is that gasoline? Where is it?
Oh, there it is. Oh, my
God. It was so close to you.
Now, can anyone tell me what kind of shark that was? What kind of shark?
Great white?
Nope, sorry, we're going for plastic. That was a plastic shark. Housewives. Now, they had a whopping 8 seasons on ABC, and they shot all at... Whoa, okay. I'm sorry, do you guys see this on your left-hand side, that black Dodge Charger?
It's
parked on the grass. It's not supposed to be. I have to call this into security. I'm sorry, guys. Just give me 1 second. Hello, security? Can you hear me?
This is security. What's going on, studio tour?
Hey, security. Cody here. So we're just coming by Wisteria Lane, and there's a black Dodge Charger parked on the grass. Can you look into it or send someone out?
Okay, tour. I'll send someone down to check it out ASAP.
Okay, cool. Thanks. All right. Sorry, guys. Security's number... Whoa, that was really fast. Hello?
Studio tour.
Yeah.
Looks like we might have an issue.
Okay.
I'm patching you into Agent Novak from the FBI.
Wait, what?
I'm sorry to interrupt your fun, but we've got video surveillance on that charger you all saw. We ran it through the system, and the driver has been positively identified as Dominic Toretta.
Oh, God.
I've been tracking this guy for...
Well set. The actual production took up not one soundstage, no. Not 2 soundstages, 11. 11 soundstages. It was the largest production we've had here on the Universal lot. However, you guys might notice there are no more Who's in Whoville. That's not because of the Grinch. It's because of their neighbor, Norman Bates, from the movie Psycho. That is the original Bates Motel there on your right-hand side. I hear the bed and breakfast is to die for. There's Norman hanging out in the office. It's kind of hot out. Anybody feel like taking a shower? No? No takers? Okay. Now, funny thing about the movie Psycho, it happens to be my favorite movie. It came out in 1960, and during that time, violence on film was not welcome. So, director Alfred Hitchcock found very clever ways around that. Anytime you guys saw blood on screen, it was actually chocolate syrup. And you guys might remember, it was a perfectly violent movie. However, you never actually saw anyone getting stabbed. Rather, you saw the motion and you heard the sound effect. Now, that sound effect was actually the sound of a knife plunging into a helpless melon. And on your left-hand side is the Bates house. I wonder if Mother's home. But you know what, guys? We're going to leave the world of Psycho behind and take you to a different world. Our world. And the world of the worlds set. Now, War of the Worlds was directed by Steven Spielberg, and it starred Tom Cruise and Dakota Fanning. You guys see this airplane on your left-hand side? It might look real to you. That's because it is. That is a real 747 that Steven Spielberg purchased from a junkyard, cut into pieces, delivered here on Mack trucks, and then, of course, destroyed for this moment in the movie. And if you guys take a look at all of the set decoration here, keep in mind, this moment in the movie lasted for 3 minutes. All of this for 3 minutes.